Evan is on your side now with another warning for beachgoers this summer. For the second time in just a week, a beach umbrella has impaled a sunbather. The latest happened just over the weekend in Ocean City at 54th Street. That umbrella was picked up by heavy wind gusts and it pierced a woman in her chest. She was flown to the hospital. Amazingly, her injuries are not life-threatening. And then last week, an umbrella impaled a woman's foot on a New Jersey beach. 7 on Your Side reporter Nathan Baca joins us in studio now with how to avoid these beach dangers. Nathan.
Well, Allison, we bought this beach umbrella at a major store for $10. These are the type of inexpensive umbrellas beach patrols warn people about. A wind gust picks it up, and this point right here can come slamming down on your body from above. Now, just as 7 on Your Side's Kimberly Suter showed you last week, video of beach umbrellas taking flight in Canada. Even professionally installed umbrellas picked up by strong winds in Ocean City, Maryland in 2015. These umbrellas can come down with force, impaling people. The last reported death we could find in the area was a woman impaled by a beach umbrella in 2016 in Virginia Beach. Now, here's what beach captains tell us. Tilt your umbrella into the wind. Use a shovel to get it deep into the sand, and an umbrella pole should be shorter than 7 feet. Now, another important number beach patrol captains want you to remember, 18 inches. That's about from fingertip to about elbow or so. That's how far in the sand a beach umbrella needs to be dug in for safety. Guys?
Important information, Nathan. Scary. Thank you. That is frightening. Especially